Howdy, folks, and welcome back to another fantastic game of War Stories, where our baggy pants devils, the boys of the 82nd Airborne, 505th Parachute Infantry Regiment, 1st Battalion, Baker Company, 2nd Platoon, 1st Platoon, 2nd Squad, are in the process of Operation Husky, the Allied effort to move in and retake Sicily for the Allies. The initial jump wasn't going super great. They ran into troubles almost immediately. But they fought through it in the little groups of paratroopers where they could assemble, fighting together in small units until they could coagulate and form larger, more cohesive groups. It was here that they've recently taken Hill 421. This is near an Italian airfield that they have been given the objective of securing. At the top of this hill, they've rallied with their battalion commander, Lieutenant Colonel Arthur Gorm. And having taken a significant amount of Italians prisoner, with relatively few losses, things are overall going their way so far. They have some scattered contact with the German forces, but predominantly it's been Italians, and predominantly they've been surrendering. Where we find ourselves now is in the evening of July 11th, 1943, when our intrepid heroes have been tasked to start making their way down this hill. Because the revelation has been made that there is a hill nearby, which has a really good view. And it's here that we will pick up tonight, as our boys are up on the hilltop, currently in the process of getting their marching orders from Lieutenant Colonel Gorm. And that's where we will dive in. So you guys find yourselves in this evening time having secured the top of this hill. You are getting a brief respite and standing by for your actual marching orders. The sounds of gunfire in the distance are continuous. It echoes through the night as this fog kind of starts to seep in the evening hours, as you've started to notice over the past night. It comes in thick, it stays thick through most of the night. It's great because nobody really wants to do anything in the fog because no one can see each other, and nobody wants a friendly fire incident. So everyone seems to mostly just kind of buckle down and sit tight in the deep fog. It's here as this fog is starting to set in, as the sun is starting to set, that you are all currently at your rally point at the top of Hill 421. So you baggy pants devils, what would you guys like to do? What are you doing when you stand by?
I'm missing the grenade launcher.
Say again?
I'm getting familiar with the grenade launcher.
Okay.
I'd like to get some good stretches in.
There we go. As you're...
I got resting up against like a little wall or a crate or something. Got a cigarette in the mouth and just cleaning my rifle.
There we go. Cleaning the rifle as you guys are relaxing, kind of smoking a cigarette if you've got them. The radio kind of crackling nearby that's been set up for communications by the battalion staff. It's going to be the new lieutenant for your platoon, actually, who comes up to you with a little bit of a worried look on his face. Formerly Sergeant Ellington, now Second Lieutenant Ellington. He's kind of turns the radio down for a second. All right, gather around, guys.
What's going on, LT?
Hot two.
As you get a little bit closer, he starts laying out the map ahead of you. So here's the situation. While we have been kind of busy out here, the Axis has been busy too. And looks like so have the rest of the boys from the 505th. Colonel Gavin has pushed up south of us, and he's got himself situated on a ridge. He and the troops that he's got gathered with him have been holding off column after column. If these armored columns break past him, it's a straight shot all the way down to the beach, and they push our boys back into the water. What we're going to try and do is move through this ridiculous fog without getting killed, go around behind these Germans, try and mess with their lines.
Yeah, pincer movement, I like it.
Kind of pauses for a second as he sits down. Who's got a smoke?
You go, LT.
One.
Oh, yeah, thanks. I'm going to be honest with you. This one's going to be tough.
Ain't nothing we ain't used to.
That's a spirit. All Americans. We handle anything they throw our way.
Sir.
So here's the long and the short of it. We're going to move out small groups, 4 or 5 guys at a time, infiltrate, move through. If you see somebody, remember the call sign. Thunder, flash. If you run into the enemies, if you can, take them out silently. We start shooting, close our pincer. Lastly, once we get up there, we need to find their communications line and cut it. That's specifically our job. If you look at the map, it kind of unrolls it in front of you. There's couple of small houses right about here that have some power lines that run by them. My guess is that's possibly a relay station. We're going to move in there. We're going to take it out. I'm going to be going with you guys on this one. We're going to do it live. Lieutenant Colonel Gorm is going to be pushing up with us. So do not forget to think twice before you shoot somebody. Because if you shoot one of us, God help you. Patton himself will string you up. Do you have any questions?
No, sir, none come to mind.
Ready to cause some chaos, LT.
I like it. That worries me coming from you, but I like it in general.
It's worked out so far.
You got a bazooka?
Yes, sir.
We got to get used to this whole sir business. Okay. You got a round in there right now?
Yes, sir.
Grab one more. That's all they can afford.
Sounds good.
Make those shots count. I mean it. You better knock that sucker out. If I find out you popped a shot at a tank, ricochet, I'll come over there and personally smack you.
Understood.
That said, also, our main priority, cutting communications. Second priority, taking out tanks. Third priority, and this may be a second priority for me personally, find something for us to eat. We are almost out of food. We haven't been resupplied yet. Our boys are pushing up from the beach. Lieutenant Colonel Gorm thinks we're going to have a second wave coming in tonight. Boys from the 504th to reinforce us. If we do, that'll be clutch. So, when you're out there, if you hear those planes flying overhead, watch for parachutes. Those could be friendlies. If you find them, absorb them, continue with the objective. Okay.
Can do.
Kind of puts the cigarette out. Jeez. I don't know. He kind of just stares at you for a minute, Burke. I don't know about this. Don't let me down.
No, sir.
Private Riles.
On him, LT.
Sir.
You got a special mission. What I'm going to need from you is to find me some ingredients. I know you're a cook.
Yes, sir.
Well, they call you chef, right?
Raj.
I want you, when you're down there, you go rifling and looting through every building and pantry and pocket you find on every dead German and Italian. And I want you to find us some good stuff to cook with.
I can get that done.
I'm so tired of these sea rations. Kill for a hot food in my belly, you know?
Go for a nice burger right now.
That's the spirit.
How about some ribs? Slathered in barbecue sauce.
Could go for some ribs, too. I could go for a burger, honestly, but like checks his pockets. I don't think I have a nickel on me.
We'll find something good. LT, don't worry.
All right, that's the spirit. You've got 15 minutes by my watch till we move out. Private Parker kind of slings the sniper rifle that Springfield over his shoulder. Yes, sir. Colonel wants you on recon. Get down there, take up a position somewhere high, keep your eyes peeled. Yes, sir. Parker kind of looks over at the rest of you with a quick nod. Oh, see you after this one.
Be safe.
Later.
Don't get blown up, but I'll be watching. Kind of meanders down the hill by himself. The lieutenant kind of walks off for a minute as some of the other men are milling about. Two other troops come over next to where you guys are. You immediately recognize them. This is going to be Private Sanchez, along with Private Corsetti. Corsetti kind of moseying up to you, Webb. Hey, Webb, how you doing, buddy?
Hey, what's going on, Sanchez? Nice to see you.
Really, you can't even tell us apart. I'm Sanchez. That's Corsetti.
I said Sanchez.
Nah, it's fine. Hey, we look kind of alike, right? Huh? Mexicans and Italians, huh? We're practically the same. It's just suave dark hair.
Hey, you know, if there was another one of me, we'd have the same issue. So, my bad.
Maybe. I don't know. I look pretty distinct to me, but I don't know. He kind of looks at you, Riles, and like looks at you, Bert. You two guys look like you could be cousins or something. You guys cousins?
Shut up, Corsetti.
Hey, I hear we're going to go pop some tanks.
Oh, yeah.
I just hugged the bazooka and a big old smile.
Do you even know how to use that thing?
I put the rocket in here, point it that way. It goes boom.
Well, that's about the gist of it, yeah. Make sure you're close, because I know you don't know how to aim that thing beyond, like, hitting the broadside of a barn.
Oh, I'll get close.
Oh, that's the spirit.
Pop some tanks and drop some towers.
I like it. Yeah, I bought some wire cutters with me. Picked them up from some of the engineer boys. Any guys electricians or whatnot before the war?
So it was.
Not me.
Grew up on a farm.
Factory worker.
Yeah, my uncle worked at a factory out in Queens. Pays good. You a union boy?
Yep. You gotta be.
That's the truth. You ain't part of the union. What are you doing with your life?
Yep.
Well, I'm guessing you're a chef, right? Since everybody calls you chef.
Yep.
You, what is it you people cook down there? Like black-eyed peas? And like wheat. I don't really know what people down south eat, I'm going to be honest.
You know what gumbo is, Corsetti?
I never heard of gumbo. That's a part of your mouth right underneath your teeth. It's a gumbo. Ah!
I thought y'all Yanks were learned people.
I'm a scholar. Scholar and a gentleman. What about you?
We eat civilized food.
Yeah. You guys are still salty. My great-grandpappy, he fought in the war, you know. It's true. True.
Is that why you're in here?
Oh, yeah. Family legacy. Couldn't let him down. My pops was in the Great War. His dad was in the Spanish-American War, fighting all the Spaniards. His pops was in the Civil War, fighting all you dirty Confederates.
Well, I'm from Oklahoma. We weren't really mixed up in that whole business.
From Boston.
Oh, you're good then. Yeah, you're good. And Webb, what about you? What'd you do before the war?
Well, I was gonna follow my dad and work on the railroad. I helped there a little bit, and then I hopped up to join the military.
Can't say as I blame you. What with the pay and all?
The pay and the backbreaking work, yeah.
Yeah. When I joined, I mean, my opportunities was pretty little. I didn't have a whole lot of chances. It was like you're going to work for the mafia, or you're going to sell milk bottles and deliver that to some housewives, fight for a spot in a union and get kicked out because you're the last one in.
Yeah, with those options, I can't blame you.
Hey, army pay ain't great, but it's steady, right?
Right, steady job. Can't complain there.
Plus, you gotta love the scenery.
Hey, you get to travel. You're telling me you get to travel $50 a month, buddy? Yep. Don't get better than that.
Great food. Hold up a ration.
More than I ever made on the farm.
Okay, the food could use some work. I'm going to be honest on that.
Fun toys. Hold up the rocket launcher.
Hey, yeah. We got to jump out of a plane. That was pretty rough.
I never thought I'd do that. So, yeah, you're right.
It was a perfectly good plane, but then it wasn't.
Yeah.
Exactly.
But $50 extra a month. We double our pay. We did one jump. You think we're going to jump out of another plane this month? I don't think so. I think half those... No. Shot to bits. We're not jumping out of anything. We already earned $50 just by not getting killed.
I'll live like kings when we get back home.
I know that's right. Jeez. Yeah, it's kind of weird being out here. In the old country.
Yeah. Where are your family from?
They're from a little port city on the northwest side of Sicily called Salerno. Oh. Yeah. Had to flee the crime bosses over here, Sicilian mafia being what it was.
Ain't no
joke. Gotta get away from that.
Yeah. Yeah, it's rough. It's a rough existence. You run into any of the locals, watch your back, because you just might get robbed or mugged.
Mm. Same people you grew up with.
Hey, the mean streets of Brooklyn are pretty unforgiving.
Austin ain't much better.
Well, I believe that when I see it, but I ain't never been to Boston. Honestly, only time I ever seen anybody from Boston before is when I would catch a Yankees game playing the Sox.
Don't start with the Sox and the Yankees. I like you, Corsetti. I don't want a reason not to like you.
Look, man, look, he's just salty. He's just salty, okay? It was just a couple of World Series. You're mad because we got the babe, and y'all got nothing but a curse out of it.
You better hope I don't have your six, Corsetti.
He kind of like stops for a second. Shoot! And he immediately dives to the ground. He says, "Get down!" As you guys hear a bullet starting to strafe.
Oh. Dive straight down.
Hit the deck.
Hit the deck.
Okay. As all of you guys are jumping down to the ground here, let me get a nimble check.
Two successes. If I need to use one to pull someone down, I will.
One success.
Okay.
Get a success.
No successes.
I will pull Webb's ass down.
That's as slow as reflexes.
As the bullets start ricocheting around you, there is the sound of the propeller as a plane goes flying past overhead. As it flies by, just a double tap. Don Juan, success?
Yes.
Good. Chef?
Yes.
Good. Boomer, you succeeded and you pulled Webb. All of you guys get down. Let's see about Corsetti and Sanchez. As the bullets go strafing by, and there's this very loud sound with each impact, it almost goes by almost like in slow motion. But you you dive to the ground here. The bullets shoot, the plane passes by. All of you are kind of just sitting there at the moment as you realize this German plane has taken a strafing run over all of you.
Do we notice it is a German plane?
Mm-hmm. As it flies overhead in the evening light, that bright yellow nose is an immediate giveaway.
I yell, everybody good?
Anybody hit?
How far am I from that AA gun?
You're about 30 meters away from it.
I'll book it for the AA gun just in case they turn around.
Burke starts booking it. You see Corsetti kind of slowly getting up next to you, Webb. I'm good. Good, you guys good?
Yeah, man, we're solid.
Sanchez, you good?
You see where Sanchez is. He kind of is laying on the ground with his hands up over his head still. His face into the dirt.
I tap him on the shoulder. Sanchez, you good, buddy?
He doesn't say anything.
Don't do this, Sanchez. Roll him over.
You can see that as he rolls over and slumps to the side, his face has been blown off. There is a messy pile where the aircraft bullet has struck him in the face.
Turn it back over.
Yeah, I'm just going to probably say, like, God damn it, and probably throw my helmet down.
Oh. Impact around. Sorry, go ahead.
So let the LT know.
While I'm running, I'm yelling for people to help me load and crank.
Okay, you're booking it now. Call in for assistance. Are any of you guys running to the aid on that?
Yeah, I'll run over there.
Okay. Yeah, I'll go give him a hand.
So as Webb is kind of attending to Sanchez, Corporal Donald's Private Riles booking it over. All of you get over to the through this gun emplacement. And as you do, I mean, the gun itself is still intact, right? You guys had left one gun.
We blew up one, killed one
crew. Yeah, so there's two guns intact. Are all three of you manning one gun?
Those AA guns are what, two to operate?
It's going to be about three. You got one person adjusting, one person that's actually firing, and one person loading. Because this is an 88 millimeter like exploding cannon.
While I'm running, I'll be like, someone get on that goddamn AA gun. Like while we're running towards one of them.
Okay. See, there's a couple soldiers as you're sprinting by. The three of you, I guess, are going towards the same gun?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I'd say so.
You got it. On one of the other guns here, booking it, it's three other soldiers. It's kind of hard to tell in the night who exactly those guys are. But they are buddies all the same. They run to the one cannon. You guys run to the other. Theirs is the one that was a little bit more in. Yours is the one that's out on the ledge.
Okay.
The cannon is currently just facing to the south.
I'll start cranking it around to the direction of the plane.
Okay. You've got it. Yeah. So go ahead and make me a... call this a tech check.
For your aim.
Who's going to be my loader?
I can load.
All right, so go ahead.
Eight dice.
Yeah, make me a heavy weapons check to get this next round and its charge put in. And then, Chef, you're going to be my fire.
Yeah, I guess so. I'm in a seat.
You're going to be a tech check as well.
Three successes.
Here we go.
No successes, but no one, so I'm going to push my luck on that one.
Okay.
Could I help him out with one of my successes and gets an extra dice?
You got a success, right?
Two.
Okay, two, and then
Donald, I got three.
Hey, you had one?
I still did not get a success.
Okay. Let's double check this then.
Would I be able to give him one of my techs? Or since, no, it's heavy weapon, right?
Yeah, he's trying to get it loaded. You get it, you get the ammo, and you're kind of struggling to find where the charging powder is. And the disarray that it's been largely left at. It works out okay because it was still loaded when you killed this crew. With the round in there, Private Burke, do you want to up the damage or take lucky
shots? Yes, I'll up the damage.
You've got it. And Chef.
I'll just aim straight for that plane.
Got it. Chef, you... so you're watching through the sight as it kind of traverses around, and you see that plane kind of coming around and starting to bank around for a second attack run.
You just hear me. You just hear me mumbling, "Come on, you son of a bitch!"
As you get the weapon in here, go ahead.
Does my extra success mean anything on my roll?
Yeah. So you can up the damage on yours.
I'll say yeah. I'll up the damage along with Boomer's damage.
You've got it. As you get the round chambered, you blast the shell out of the cannon. It lets loose with an explosive roar. Almost deafening, because none of you had been really expecting just how loud this cannon is. But it blasts explosively through the night. And you see the round fly out and impact. Let me get one of you guys to roll me a D10, please.
And then that is plus, because you had three successes, right?
Mm-hmm.
So then it's plus three to whatever it is.
If I rolled, an eight.
Okay.
An eight on the dice or an eight total?
Eight on the dice.
Okay. All of them were at 11.
Plus three to push it into a critical. All right. Mm. There we go. So let's find out where this critical hits. Let me get somebody else to roll a d10.
Sure. Go ahead, Donald.
That's a four.
Four is going to be main body. And let me get main body crits. Chef, roll me another d10. Let's see how bad you wreck this bad boy.
Eight.
Concussive hit. The attack rocks the vehicle with a terrible concussion. Crew are stunned by the blast for 1d6 rounds, minus successes on a stamina check. Let's see if this pilot is able to pull it together after getting rocked by a flak blast. He only has a single success out of four rounds. As it impacts, you can see the smoke and the fire start trailing through the evening sky as it starts diving down slowly losing its altitude. And you can see the pilot actually jumps out and a parachute open only a couple of seconds before the plane just fireballs into the ground itself.
How far is that pilot?
Looks like he's probably close to about a kilometer out.
Is he north or south of us?
North.
Can I take a look at like the general direction that plane was coming from when it hit for that strafing run and see if I can see any other planes coming in?
Absolutely. Go ahead and make me a perception check, please.
Love to.
I'd also like to look if that's all right.
Yeah, go ahead.
It's two successes.
Okay. And what did you have for Private Burke?
Two successes.
There we go. Both of you see that there are other planes. There's two other fighters. They are strafing Colonel Gavin's troops down at Biazza Ridge to the south.
Oh, yeah, Donald's racket.
All right.
We'll start.
Yeah, can we start adjusting?
Cranking in that direction.
And yeah, start. Like, can we clearly see that these other two planes are German?
Oh, yeah. I mean, these bright yellow noses, I mean, you can strongly tell.
Cool. Just making sure. Yeah, we'll start doing that. And then I guess while, because I imagine it's going to take a second to like adjust aim for like those other planes. Can I like maybe take another look around and try and get this bad boy reloaded?
Yeah, go ahead. And yeah, because you did fire your round. So it does need to get a reload. So go ahead and make another heavy weapons check. Let's get a tech check from Private Burke for the aim. And then a tech check from Private Riles for the release point.
I will, I'll yell at the other team. I'll turn around. They're over there. I'll try to help if they, in case they didn't perceive them.
Okay.
One success on the reload.
One on month.
Okay.
Seven, eight. I can do tech checks all day. One, two, three, four successes out of eight dice.
There we go. All right. You want a lucky strike? Bump the damage?
Bump it.
Got it. First thing that happens is that it starts moving around. As soon as that last round had fired off, the breach opens. It comes back ejecting this large artillery-like shell. Private Donald, at this point, as you've taken the time while they were aiming, you have located where the shells are and where the powder is. You've got three shots left. You immediately get the shell itself, place it in the breach with a ramming rod by yourself, this task that usually takes several people. Mash it up quickly, grab one of the powder bags, set it behind, mash it in, shut the breach. As soon as it's down, at this point, the Private Burke has rotated the gun its full 45 degrees, and you're now going to be leading the planes as they come around in this arc. You've got your shot lined up for you, Private Riles. You wait with the fine adjustments. Take your actual shot. You see that yellow nose start to enter in towards your sights. Timing it, release. Another concussive explosion. The round goes shooting out. I get somebody to roll a d10 for the damage.
Ready. Let's see. Come on. Be good to me. 9.
Plus 3.
That was going to be another crit. Okay, let's get a D10 for that hit location, please.
3.
3, still main body. And let's get a D10 for what that crit do.
4.
Battering explosion. The blow rattles the whole vehicle. If it's moving, the pilot, in this case, must make an operate roll at -3. Where the vehicle will roll or crash at GM discretion. All right. He's normally got himself a nice big old 6 on this operate. Down 3, he's only got 3 dice. He's a successful check here to avoid wrecking this bad boy. He finds it with 1 success. at the last second as it's smoking after this hit. It just starts to kind of like level out as it kind of struggles to gain altitude. Two shells left.
Keep them coming, Donald.
All right, let's hit another reload.
All right, make all those rolls again. I'm going to roll for the crew next to you. They succeed in getting on that one. They succeed with one extra on the aim.
Let's go.
Two successes.
They miss on the shot itself. It explodes nearby but doesn't impact. Okay. Success on the loader?
Yep.
All right.
I got two.
Awesome. You like to boost the damage, Lucky Strike?
I'll boost the damage.
Okay.
I got three.
There we go. All right.
I only got two out of eight dice.
Hey, that's still good. So
still plus.
Plus three total, yeah?
No, because I got three, so that's
one,
plus
two, three,
two,
four.
Four?
Because four.
I got one extra.
Bumping the damage then?
Yep.
I'm just going to keep the damage bumping.
You got it. The shell comes in. Are you targeting the same one, or are you targeting his wingman?
I see the same one.
Yeah.
Okay. Shifting it around, following him as he traverses. He's starting to come around now and actually comes straight in towards you, kind of one wing up high as he's about to level out. Get the cannon turned around at the last second here. Right as it's coming into aim, Chef, you're sitting on the trigger, waiting. You can feel the anticipation. Rounds are starting to light up from the nose. The rounds coming out of this BF-109 straight from the nose in the center with this blinking yellow light. You can hear the as the rounds impact around. Let the round go, having successfully aimed it. Stout, let's get a D10 roll for damage.
I just smirk as I say bye. Six.
Oh.
Okay, so plus four is 10.
10.
That's still a crit. You guys are rocking this bad boy. All right, let's get a D10 for location.
Two on that one.
This will be the armament. And another D10 for what that damage do.
Six.
Okay. Let's see. This is mostly based for a tank. Let's fix this for a plane in this case.
Right in the prop.
All right. You, this would be a jamming of the turret normally. He's going to have to make an operate test. Instead of the turret, we're going to say that you'll possibly affect the bomb on the undercarriage. We'll have him do his operate check. See if he's able to retain that. He's not. So as it explodes outward, it's not actually a bomb, rather, but a fuel tank. And as the flak round explodes in the underbelly, the fuel tank ignites, and there is just one rapid it explodes in thin air, and the trailing pieces go shooting out past it, skittering across the ground. You have one round left.
I'm trying to track the wingman. Do we see him?
The wingman is lined up on y'all, and he's making his attack run now.
Oh, look, perfect shot.
All right.
Rocket!
That is going to be one success coming in here. Pull up his gun. I did not roll enough dice for that.
That's all right.
Still just one success. And that is going to be... Let's see. Blasting out about 60 rounds on this concussive boost here. This is going to be a plus three damage. Oof. All right, let's see. I'm going to roll a D6 first. If it's odds, it targets your gun. If it's evens, it targets the other guy's gun. Evens it is. You luck out as the rounds impact, and you see the guys nearby you get sliced and shredded like cheddar cheese as their bodies crumple to the ground. Let's roll our checks to see with your last round here.
Eight. Six, seven, eight.
I got one.
1.
Gets loaded in.
3.
Oh.
A round quickly chambered as you slice it up. It almost kind of scuffs your wrist a little bit. With the intensity you slam it in, the adrenaline absolutely pumping full force through all of you. Burke, you realign it. This guy's coming in from a little bit to the left of the first one. It doesn't take a whole lot, so you've got him there in your sights quick. Riles, you're waiting for the perfect moment. You know that there's a spot where he's coming in that he's probably going to start pulling it up. So you're aiming just a little bit above the nose as he's coming in straight. Let's go ahead and roll that D10 for the damage. Plus, how many extra? We had 2 extra successes?
I think so.
Yeah. 7.
Okay.
So plus 9.
Plus yeah. 2.
It's not going to crit. That's still good damage. As it explodes, a kind of shrapnel shatters into the wing of it, peppering the cockpit as it flies by overhead, trailing smoke. Not shot down, but damaged.
Can I run over to where the other gun was that got shredded up in that run? Yeah. And see if I can scavenge like another round for our cannon?
You got it. Make a perception check for me.
Certainly. 115, and that one's cocked. 2 successes.
Okay, you do find that they have 2 more rounds, an appropriate powder for these rounds to be fired off. But as you're standing, getting these shells amidst the shattered, ripped apart bodies of your comrades, some of whom are not completely dead yet, are still in the process of gurgling out, need a guts from you. Steal your will through this carnage.
Okay, so that's gonna be, I have 3, 1 in the guts, and I have cool head, but I'm still affected on my morale, so it's only gonna be 4 die. No successes, but again, no ones. I'm going to push it.
Okay.
All right, I got a success and a 1, so that's a FUBAR.
All right, so my FUBAR count now is...
I should have 2 on me.
Okay, 2 for Don Juan. And I know I've got 2 for Chef. Burke, do you have any?
No, sir.
Okay, and Webb, do you have any?
Might have been used.
Okay. You got it. We'll get to what's happening to you all this time, Webb, in just 1 second.
I figured.
Yeah. Not just leaving it.
Webb, just enjoy the show.
Like, wow, that's cool. Okay. Let's see. So you pushed it. You did get a 1 success, right?
Yeah, I got a success and a 1.
Okay, there's a moment as you get the 2 rounds slung up over your shoulders, heavy as they are, or rather a round and a cartridge, as you feel a grip on your leg, right around your ankle, you can see the top half of this soldier as he's kind of looking up at you terrified, grabbing onto your ankle, and you could hear him just kind of quietly crying, "Mama! And as his eyes roll back in his head and the grip gets loose, you have to force your will through it, but you push, knowing that this is going to keep happening if you can't take out this other one.
Man, we got to get these guys down.
And goes limp as you run past him. The other one of these Messerschmitts is looking like he's climbing, trying to gain altitude now, departing from the hilltop. As you get your rounds over, give me a calisthenics check for this run here.
Yeah, sure.
Because these are not light. Like, this is usually...
Yeah, no, I figured I was going to have to do at least 1. That's 1 success.
Okay. As you are sucking every bit of air that's on the top of this hill, you come hauling it over to your crew with the ammo. You've got another shot.
All right.
Start lining that up. While he was doing that, I'm And I'm cranking the aim.
Okay. Yeah, let's make our checks again.
Load. One success.
Three successes.
Two successes.
Hey, there we go. Now we're cooking with fuego. Okay. The round gets quickly chambered in. You've got the sight. You've just been kind of tracking it this whole time, Burke, as it's coming around and gaining that altitude, just slowly following it, adjusting your elevation and your azimuth as it moves, making sure that you're going up a little bit quicker than you move over to stay tracking on it. Chef, you're waiting for the right moment. You've got him in your sights. You hear from Corporal Donald's the all clear. Fire the shot. Another explosive eight. Round. Eight on the damage, plus how many extra successes?
Three.
Hell of a lot, right? You had three?
No, I think it's three total.
Oh, it was three right? total?
Yeah, because I had I had two extra.
Okay.
Yeah, and I had one extra, so that's three, I think.
You got it. So with these three extra successes, 8 plus 3?
Right? 11.
Yeah. 11.
That's a crit, so let me get a... first off, or next up, a location.
10.
There we go. Okay. Pulling up that table, guys. Give me one sec.
All good.
With a 10, you're going to... Nope. Those are people. I want vehicles. With a 10, that's going to hit the engine / fuel tank. All right, and we get another 10 for what that shot does.
9.
Fuel on fire. Fuel tank is ruptured. Vehicle is immobilized on fire. Everyone on board, 8 dice from the blast as well as an attack from the fire. All right, so it Jeez. Immediately erupts into flames. Let's just check and see. An 8 dice attack from the blast. I don't know if the pilot's gonna survive that bad boy. That's 2 successes. That's going to be a pretty bad hit.
Did you also add the 1 for the fuel for the fire damage? It was 8 plus 1.
Oh yeah, let's roll one more. Okay, yeah, still the same. As it bursts into flames, it kind of slowly starts corkscrew spiral out of control. You see no parachute as it impacts into the ground relatively near the airfield.
Do we feel the foof?
What you feel is a moment of concern. Because you look out to the south now, as a couple of the other guys have called attention. Private Webb, you're going to be the one that's finding this. As they are located on that, you can hear the shouting from Lieutenant Ellington. Webb, you good?
Sir, Sanchez, he's in pieces.
Kind of comes running over and almost skidding to a stop as he comes over to where Sanchez is. He kind of rolls him onto his back, takes in a deep breath and looks away, rolls him back over slowly on his face. Kind of reaches his hand across and grabs you by the neck. You're going to be all right, soldier. There's going to be more of them. Never attack just one. Get the binoculars. Get on the lookout. We need to see if they're coming.
Right. Yes, sir. I'm on it.
I've got Sanchez. Go!
I take off with the binoculars.
Okay. You go sprinting over. Oh, it's like that music's a little loud. Sorry. You go sprinting with the binoculars to where the that large tower was that lieutenant had been manning, the Italian lieutenant.
Mm-hmm.
As you climb up here, just get the best sight. Let me get a perception check for you, please. And I'm going to give a command check from the lieutenant, see if he can give you a bonus on this. You can add one extra dice to your check.
Right.
And then do the binoculars give him a bonus as well, or?
For the distance and the fact that it's at night, I'm going to say it'll just negate the disadvantage or okay. The negative modifier.
All right, I got two successes.
Okay. As you start looking out and around, what you see is far to the south, as you're not too incredibly far from the coast still. The entire second wave, 504th Parachute Infantry Regiment, on their way to come reinforce you, getting absolutely blasted by anti-aircraft fire coming from only 100 or so feet below them, right near the water where the fleet is currently at anchor supporting. And this is where we'll bring to a quick errata from our previous one. The boys of the 505th, when you guys came in for this attack initially, on the 9th/10th. It was not actually the friendly fire from American ships that you guys took. It was exclusively from the Axis. Tonight is the night that that friendly fire incident takes place. And as you're looking out there, Webb, you're watching plane after plane just explode or burst into flames. The formation starts to scatter. Very few planes are kind of maintaining their current course towards you.
Self back down, get ready to relay the information.
Quickly hurry back down the ladder. As you can see, the lieutenant is nearby. He's in the process right now of getting that radio up and working.
LT, got some bad news for you.
Send it to me quick.
Looks like those planes aren't going to make it.
Kind of looks over at you as you hear the rounds impacting as the first strafing run goes by. Or I'm sorry, this will be the next strafing run comes by. Took out the crew on the second anti-aircraft gun. You're not sure if those were your buddies or the other guys. You just watched one of these anti-aircraft guns just wiped.
That's only one of them, sir. Got a night ahead of us. We get to shelter.
What do you mean the planes aren't going to make it?
The anti-air out there, it's not handling up.
Kind of looks over. Binoculars.
Here.
Takes them from you and starts looking in the direction you've pointed out. Oh, man. He sits back for a moment, just kind of stunned at it. And the fact that they're losing so many friendlies in this moment here, the radio starts firing up. As he starts calling it in. Hey, this is Lieutenant Ellington. Yeah, I don't care. We don't have time for that. They're shooting our boys. Tell them to cancel their fire. Tell the ships to stop shooting. They're hitting friendlies. How copy? I say again. They're attacking friendly aircraft. Cease fire. See him just kind of frustrated, just throw the phone that's connected to the radio across the ground. It kind of skids in the dirt.
What happened, OT? Talk to me.
Say we need time to confirm it. We'll reach out to them and let you know.
We got bodies flying out the sky. Our bodies.
He kind of takes his helmet off on the ground, just dropping it, runs his hands through this blonde hair. He's clearly very distressed by this. There's a little bit of a respite and a cheer around you as you hear an explosion in the distance. Kind of instinctively looking over, you see one of the planes just explode into flames, and one of these German planes that's been attacking you.
Well, there's a little good news. We got one of those baddies coming at us, strafing runs. Little victories.
Take them where we can get them, right?
That's all we can do.
Okay. Let's make our way over. Let the boys know we gotta head down there now. All this fire is gonna call a whole lot of attention on us. We gotta get down there if we're gonna have any chance of getting the Spencer in. You have your radio on you?
Yes, sir. I got it right here.
All right, let's go.
Roger that.
He picks up his Thompson submachine gun as he starts going around past you. As you're running by, you feel a hand kind of grab you as you're running. Kind of gets you right by the arm, Private Webb.
I turn around, see who it is.
The face you see staring back at you is the angry face of First Lieutenant Jonas. Private, where the hell do you think you're going? You're trying to run away just because we get shot a couple times?
LT, I just got orders to go down with the other LT. I'm headed right behind him.
That's a load of malarkey. You're a coward. You're running away.
I'm not running away. I'm the one. I just went up and got intel for us. I'm ready to go for the fight. I'm here for the fight.
Bullshit. You're a coward trying to run away.
And what makes you think that, sir?
See, there's the moment where he just like looks at you from head to toe. Not hard to tell how your type is. Sergeant, arrest this man.
Arrest. See, one of the
sergeants comes over like very confused.
What's going on here? What am I being arrested for? Don't touch me.
You see the sergeant kind of like is coming over closer to you, but is still like, what? What happened, sir? This man is a coward running away from combat.
You obviously see me. Y'all see me, right? It's not just me.
See, the sergeant kind of like looks at you confused and is like subtly nodding, but not sure what to do. Sergeant, arrest that man now, or you will face trial for disobeying a direct order as well. See, the sergeant next to you kind of begrudgingly unslings his Thompson. Yes, sir. Kind of grabs you by the arm. Come on, Private.
I still don't understand. This is crazy. Why are you doing this to me?
As he kind of grabs you by the arm and starts leading you away, you hear the lieutenant behind you. Cannot stand the face of cowardice in front of the enemy. Despicable. How in the hell did we allow this sort of ridiculous situation to occur in the first place? I don't understand why people like him are allowed. And he kind of trails off as the sergeant leads you away.
Yeah, I shout for LT. LT!
As you're shouting for him, it's kind of hard to see in the fog. The sergeant who's got you by the arm kind of releases his grip.
And I can jerk away and start running towards where LT ran towards.
You take off running. You can see the sergeant behind you with his Thompson submachine gun in his hands. Slings it over his shoulder. Kind of tips the helmet to you as you're running off.
I just keep running and yelling, LT! I don't even register that they stopped behind me.
As you as you're shouting it out, you hear Lieutenant Ellington. Webb, that you?
Yes, sir. I need help.
A couple seconds pass by as you see the LT running. He's coming at like a full sprint. Not exactly at you, but like a little bit adjacent, until he kind of like catches sight of you in the fog and comes to a quick stop. What's good? You hurt? You hit?
I'm arrested. Lieutenant Ellington just said I was showing cowardice and arrested me.
Lieutenant Jonas.
Sorry.
He's like, the hell?
Yeah. I don't know what's going on.
I know one thing. That guy's an idiot. We'll deal with that later if that's even a thing, which it's not. I counter his order. What a stupid order. You got your stuff?
Yeah, I'm good. Let's go. I'm ready.
Don't let idiots like that in your head.
I got it. I clap my head twice, my helmet twice. Say, all right, I'm in the zone. Let's do this.
You got this. Okay, let's go. I'm going to go over to the gun. Go grab Corsetti. Meet back with me.
Roger that.
As he takes off, let me open this. Why won't you? He goes running by, going over towards the cannon. You can see Corsetti. He's got his Garand in hand, and he's kind of looking up around the sky.
Corsetti, before you, calm down. We're headed down with the LT.
What?
We're headed down with the LT. We got sight of friendlies needing assistance. We need to act faster than start the pincer. We got to get down now.
All right, let's go. Let's go.
Let's roll.
As he comes with you, the rest of you see the lieutenant running up to you and kind of barking out to you guys. Hey, everybody good?
Yeah, we're good. Nobody hit.
Good shooting.
We're good, LT.
All right.
The other crew wasn't so lucky.
Kind of looks over to the other gun.
Yet.
For Sanchez, I don't have time for this. We got to push out. Sergeant Taylor, identify those men, collect their tags, report it up on the radio. Stand by here. Call back if we need your help. See Sergeant Taylor, formerly Corporal Taylor, kind of nod back. Yes, sir. So he kind of slowly makes his way over to where the other group been gunned down. A couple seconds later, PFC Webb and Private Corsetti come running up to you.
Hey guys, looks like I missed the fireworks.
That's all right. We made enough for everyone. Let's get down there and help our boys.
Let's do it.
Roger that.
As you rally around behind the lieutenant, let me get an infiltrate check for the squad here.
It's agility, right?
Yeah.
There we are. I got 3 successes.
1 success.
Big goose egg.
Oof. One success.
Anybody want to help out your buddy?
Yeah, I was going to say, can I help out Riles? You said you didn't pass it, or?
Yes.
Yeah, can I help him out with one of those?
Yeah, so take another dice to roll.
We are good to go.
All right. For a little bit of touch and go, your pack is rattling in a weird way, but it's a quick little adjustment from your buddy to cinch down straps on it that holds it a lot tighter to you.
Get that muscle tight.
Must have got caught on that damn A gun.
Moving your way down the hill, you can see the gunfire below you. It's kind of to your west, as there are multiple tanks down in the valley below, actively engaging Colonel Gavin's troop on Piazza Ridge.
Get ourselves a tank, boys.
Bag us a couple.
That's what you've been waiting for, Boomer.
Time to work my magic.
Can't wait to see it.
I'm progressing down this hill. You very discreetly move by. And as it comes a little bit more into the open spaces nearby, there's a pretty fortunate batch of high grass that you're able to find. And it's in this kind of tall grass where you get yourselves with a good vantage point on the building. It looks like there's probably actually two buildings by this road. And it's taken you the better part of the night as we've come into the early hours of the 12th now, probably about 3, maybe 4 a.m. Fog is still thick.
You can How far are the houses? I'm sorry.
No, you're good. It's probably about 100 meters out.
The tanks?
The tanks have been moving down this road sporadically. The majority of the fighting is probably about maybe 2 kilometers to the south of you.
So they're not firing from static emplacements. They're roaming around.
Oh, they're actively engaging the ridge.
Okay.
This road seems to be how they're traversing it.
Okay. And do we see any sort of, like, is there like a bridge or something that that they're going across, anywhere along this road?
This ground out here is very largely flat and open, with occasional little scrub brushes and relatively few trees. You've been taking advantage of slightly taller grass, but even this grass normally will only come up to about your waist. You've all been having to kind of crouch low to move through it, just your heads and shoulders popping up.
And it's probably further away from the road, right? Not right on it.
LT, you want us to check out those buildings?
Yeah.
Want us to level them?
Not yet. That'll give us away.
I could set charges.
Not yet. Time may come for that. But
yes, sir.
If we take this place, we're going to want it. We can repair those lines and use them for ourselves. I just need them disabled, not destroyed.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Who's got hands for that, Boomer? That's you?
Yeah.
Corsetti next to you kind of slaps the very thick pair of wire cutters that he has strapped through his belt, his utility belt.
Do you know how to use those, Corsetti?
Do I know how to use? Of course I know how to use these things.
All right, let's go.
All right.
Pop so many locks with these bad boys. I mean, not these ones specifically, but yeah, you get the picture.
Let's talk and we're walking. Let's go.
All right. Jeez. Yeah. Kind of falls in line. Let me get a marching order for you guys here. Approaching this house.
I'm pretty good at slipping around unnoticed. So I feel like I'd be towards the front, kind of like leading the way, checking in, like, you know, hand signs, calling people forward and stuff.
Okay.
I'll be on the left side of the column so that I can hear them.
You've got it.
I'll be on the right side of the column.
So we got Boomer on the left. On the right, we've got Webb.
I'll probably just stay like closer to like middle.
Middle back?
Yep.
Making a diamond formation. I like it. Approaching this house, your weapons at the ready, locked and loaded. Let me get a perception check from all of you.
Okay.
Three successes.
Jesus.
We're only 7 dice.
Didn't get it.
Okay. Cero.
Claro.
Sorry, my thing just closed. There we go. One success.
Okay. And that was 3 for Burke, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Webb and Burke, the two of you, kind of on the sides, more attentive to the periphery. Webb, on the right side, you're going to hear that there are vehicles that are kind of on the approach. They're a bit of a distance out, but they're moving towards you. And Burke, you're going to notice that inside the larger of these two buildings, there is voices. You can hear people that are talking. Can't make out what they're saying yet. And you can see a little bit of flickering light from like a cigarette being lit.
Can I make out the language that they're talking in?
Not at this distance yet, no.
Okay, so I just kind of like, and I, you know, say two ahead.
Is it a straight line from where the vehicles are coming, or are they coming right at us?
The road kind of runs perpendicular to the direction that you guys are headed, and the building is on the far side of that road.
Okay. I don't know. Vehicles approaching. Two.
All right. Let's get in there quick and quiet.
You know, I say we swing around behind him, try to take him out nice and quiet.
Sounds good.
Should we wait for the vehicles?
How far are they?
Did I get a sense of that?
Can't see in the fog, but you can tell that they're coming.
Okay. So, all right, get down. Let them pass.
Yeah. Good idea.
Okay. All of you kind of instinctively drop to the deck using this thick, tall grass. And you can feel the vibration. Starts kind of rattling a little bit, and then the gears kind of grinding gets a little bit louder.
Sound like a tracked vehicle?
Definitely. A few more moments pass by. Up to you.
I'm not the one with the bazooka.
No.
I'm not smart, but I ain't stupid.
As it continues to roll by through the darkness and the fog, moving past you, the sound of it gradually gets less. He's a little bit out of earshot.
I look over at Donald's, like, expectedly.
Right. I think we get at least two men to move in. If we all want them, just move in as quietly as we can.
You want to sneak around the back?
Mm-hmm.
Roger that.
Okay, so we're moving on.
I'll pull out the combat knife and my 1911.
You got it. The knife comes out as you start kind of slinking around behind this building here.
Take out my knife, like, and I'll smear some mud on my face.
Like one real clear notch in the back of the knife.
Very impressive display here, as you guys are sneaking around behind. Let me get a follow-up perception check from you, Corporal.
Can do. Success?
One success?
Yeah, just the one.
Okay. The voices inside seem to have stopped talking for the moment, but you do hear the kind of click, click, click of a lighter trying to light.
Okay. How close am I to this building and where these guys are now?
Right now, I'd say you're not too terribly far. Probably only about 15 feet out.
Okay. Can I like just sneak up ahead and try and find like a window or like a cracked door or something so I can put eyes on whatever's inside?
Absolutely. You very slowly move. Let me get one more nimble check. Infiltrate check.
Infiltrate? Okay, yeah.
Sorry.
From the corporal or from all of us?
From just the corporal here.
Okay.
Yeah. That's 3 successes.
There we go. Okay. You are nimble. You are stealth. And you move up. Getting closer and closer. You can get all the way up to where you're now, just with your back up against the wall itself. There's a little window slit that you kind of are able to peer through. Inside in the darkness, you can see that there are two people there standing.
Okay. Sort of give the eyes like, and then I'll point out at Riles, since like motion for him to move up with me.
Yep, I'll move up.
Okay. You move up as well here. And you get to where you're getting pretty close. Let me get one more nimble infiltrate check from you. I keep saying nimble. I really like nimble.
One nimble success. Better for me.
Very slowly kind of rolling your steps as you get closer. You get right behind the corporal with your back up against the wall here. You can hear the creaking of wood as these individuals within are kind of stepping around.
Okay. And did I see pretty clearly they're in like German uniform?
It's pitch black in there. You're barely picking up the movement, and that's mostly based on the cigarettes and the sound of the floorboards creaking.
Okay. Yeah, I guess I'll motion for Riles to move in, and then I want to try and get in as close as we can to these guys and try and take them out quiet.
Okay. Weren't there some outside as well? Or were they all inside?
It was just inside here.
Oh, okay. I thought there were two outside as well.
I'm sorry. No, these two are inside the building.
Okay.
What's up?
Okay, I was thinking, if there's two inside, didn't want to have too many going in. Corporal, do you want all of us going in or some of us looking on the outskirts? I could be on the outskirts looking at the house just in case.
Yeah, I think at most two going in, and then if y'all want to keep an eye out for any more coming in or any more vehicles coming down the road.
Okay, I'll do that. I'll be on the side of the house that we entered in or entered on.
Okay, so you're going in the opposite side?
I'm staying on the outside of the house looking out at the road.
Gotcha. All right, so you're peeping the road, and Private Burke.
I haven't been getting any orders, so I'm just going to watch the road.
All right, so also taking up an overwatch. Let me get a perception check from my PFC Webb and Private Burke.
Seven. Ah. Damn it. Stop. Jumping out. Two successes.
Okay. No successes, but I'm pushing my luck.
Okay, here it is.
Wow. No successes and two foo bars.
There it is. All right.
RIP.
I got 6 foo bars right now. This is tight. Good thing you guys have some fun coming up.
I think I'm going to lose another hand.
If you're lucky.
Yeah.
Webb, as you're looking down the street here, you're not seeing anybody. Private Burke, as you're looking down the street, you hear more rumbles. as another tank is rolling its way towards where all of you guys are.
I'm gonna slowly take out my bazooka.
Okay.
Just in case. But I'm staying prone.
He's got it.
Hold that shot in there.
So with your bazooka kind of out and on standby, the gearbox is kind of grinding away down the road as it's getting closer.
I'm fighting every instinct I have to just shoot it.
You can hear it, but you can't see it. It's the worst feel.
Yeah.
Going inside the building now, we have Corporal Don Juan and Private Chef. How are you guys entering this building?
Okay. I think you said there was like two entrances to the building, right?
There's just one door at the front. And for better clarification of this building, this was probably a schoolhouse. Judging by the looks of it now that you're up close, this is probably like, think your 1800s kind of small classroom where it's almost like a church, right? Where you got your pews.
Yeah, just like a chapel or like tabernacle style.
Yeah, just a very simple classroom.
Okay. I think we just, are there any sort of like, I know that you said there was like a slit. Would it be possible for us to like try and like climb in one of these windows and open it up, or are they like boarded shut?
They're not boarded shut, but they are shut.
Okay. Can we try and open up and hop in one of these windows?
Okay. Let me get a, it's not hard enough to open, but let me get a nimble check to see how quietly you can open up these windows.
Certainly.
Is this technically climbing into a window?
This is more about being sneaky. And
all right. In
the first place, yeah.
Yeah. So nimble, not infantry. That is one success.
Okay. Jesus. Give me four successes.
There it is. You both get these windows open pretty quickly, kind of using the sound of the tank that's rolling nearby to mask your entry.
Okay. I'll try and hop in as quietly as I can.
With those successes, you're going to be able to kind of get yourself in through the windows of this large classroom, waiting until the guys inside of it are at the far wall.
Okay. I'll sort of like pull the knife and gesture to Riles to do the same.
Can I see them at all since we're in?
I mean, now that you're in here, you can see their kind of silhouettes a little bit better.
How does it look like their place? Can I make a perception check to see if like, oh, like if they're like giving off body language of like, oh shit, I hear a fucking tank, or if they're just like, oh, tank.
The two of them. Yeah, make me an insight check.
Insight? All right.
Yeah.
One success.
Okay. When the tank starts getting closer, you'll notice that both of them kind of crouch down, getting out of sight of the window.
I'm going to reach up and put my hand on Don Juan's knife and, like, lower it gently. And wait for the tank to pass. And as it passes, I'm going to, if I see them giving that kind of body language where it looks like they're trying to avoid the tank, I'm going to like kind of like look at him and be like, trust me. And as the tank treads get quiet, I'm going to say thunder, right?
Yep.
I'm going to say thunder.
Okay. The tank
may be a bad decision, but
trust it.
The tank is rolling on by here. And as it's getting close, the two of you are inside. Private Burke and UC Webb, you guys are both outside still. What are you guys doing? It's getting close now.
I see any lights? Like, is it coming straight at me or is it on the road?
It's coming down the road from the right towards the left. So from north to south.
I mean, I'll try to let it pass unless it spots us, then I'm going to open up on it.
Okay. Yeah, and I'll go on the opposite side to make sure I see it pass all the way down.
All right.
I'm prone.
Me too.
Got it. Both of you guys taking up the prone position, going around the side of the building, just waiting for it to pass.
Or is the grass tall enough to be crouched? Or
not here by this building.
Okay, yeah, no, I'm prone then.
Got it. Let me get a infiltrate from both of you as you go prone here in the open. You can add a dice to this because it is nighttime.
You're gonna need it. Or not. Two successes.
There it is.
No successes. I'm not doing that. No successes.
I mean, the good news is you can't get any more foobars. You're already maxed.
Yeah, this is true.
So
yeah.
I can just keep doing it?
Yeah, pretty much.
Right, you can only push your luck once in a roll.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. All right, I'll push it again. Push my luck. All right, there's a success.
Okay. As you kind of are struggling to like get yourself as low as you can, the silence is going to be very quickly broken. I say silence, there's a tank going by. But what all of you will hear, and the two of you outside will see, in about a split second as it's getting close, is a quick shot and an explosion. And as this explosion rocks the tank, it immediately kind of grinds to a halt, cackling with fire. Let me share the screen with you guys. You can see what exactly is going on. All right, so let me know once this is loaded up.
I see you. Yep.
Yeah, I see you.
Okay. So this is this little school building out here. We upgraded to the very fancy high quality models now. We'll keep nice. Using those kind of low quality models for the campaign map to represent units. But for the actual battle maps, as you guys can see here.
Ooh.
Yeah, we've got
mega fancy.
Yeah. Private Burke with his BAR mm-hmm. Around the other side of the building here, going to be PFC Webb, M1 Carbine, kind of sitting here and prone on standby. The two of you inside is going to be Private Riles and Corporal Donalds. I'll turn you around, check out those sweet models.
Indeed.
Nice.
And fun fact, with these guys, we can do like a kneeling. If you kind of cross down, we could do a prone. And we can most unfortunately do.
Let's not do that one.
Yeah, let's not do that.
I hope you don't see that one.
I don't like the foreshadowing.
Yeah.
So all of you guys are here. I also put Private Parker out here. He's here in spirit. But he's actually quite slow. Mm-hmm. The loud explosive burst that you heard, though, my tabs here. That explosive burst that you heard is going to be the sound of a bazooka that was firing up. And as that bazooka impacted, as the burst of light went out, you can see across the way past this flaming tank nearby you, at the far edge, two people. The one that fired the bazooka his face kind of lit up by the burning flames, very apparent to the two of you outside, is Lieutenant Colonel Gorm himself, who's fired off that bazooka shot. You can see the soldier with him very rapidly reloading as the smoldering form of this tank comes crushing through and up onto a hill where it comes to a stop. The fire is burning, and the crew let out a couple of quick screams from it as they die in the flames, struggling to escape from the burning tank. Unfortunately, that wasn't the end of the fun. It's further down the road now. There is a German on a motorcycle. Quickly comes to a stop. And he is going to hop off of his bike. Let's see. We'll just have you standing, I guess. That's fine. Actually, I think none of those are right. Bear with for a second as the follow-up motorcycle behind it is also coming in. These two dudes. Are also gonna hop out of their car. Actually, I'm gonna do a different share real quick while I look through this, so we don't have any spoilers. As I'm pulling this up, let me get you guys to go ahead and roll initiative for me.
Okay.
Also, too, just if I hear a loud explosion, I'm probably just going to immediately stand up and draw my rifle.
Okay.
Initiative the D10, right?
Yes. If we you guys have a tie, do a roll off. We'll
I got
a 7.
7 as well.
I got an 8.
The double roll offs.
Yeah, for real. All right, Webb.
All right.
I got a 7 on my second roll.
Got a 6 on my second roll.
I got a 4 on my second roll.
A 1 on my second roll.
So right, Donald's, so Webb. Donald's, Webb, Bert Riles.
Yes. And then while you're looking that up, I'm going to use the restroom.
You got it. Okay, volume for the music, by the way.
Yeah,
pretty good.
Okay, if it's too loud, tell me. I'll lower it a little bit.
I'd say if anything, maybe just a little too loud. But I can hear you all right.
Okay, I'll turn it down a tick.
2 seconds. I'll be right back.
Got it. Let me roll for these bad boys. Okay, it's a nice high roll. Okay, are we all back?
Except for Don Juan.
Okay. Did anybody write down the order here?
Yeah, it was Don Juan, Webb, Burke, me, Riles.
And what did Don Juan?
And it was
8877.
Yes. Yep.
Okay. So,
I'm back.
Welcome back. Don Juan, Webb, and then who?
Burke, Boomer. Riles.
Mm-hmm.
All right. What did Burke and Riles have?
Both had 7s.
7. Okay.
the Germans will be in between yous. It'll be Don Juan, Webb, Germans, Burke, Riles.
Easy.
These guys quickly come to a stop and are hopping out of their car. You guys have heard that gunshot. And you've heard the sound of the motorcycles coming to a stop. I'll also go ahead and tell you that the sound of that tank, while it's gone, there's another tank that's coming.
Very great.
Lovely.
Something to think about here.
What side is it coming from?
Probably the same direction that first one came down.
Okay, so to our right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. All
right. Okay. Let's pull up one more fun sound effects for us here. The fighting is a little bit more intense now. Okay, volume on the ambience?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
Trying to make that tank kind of as quiet as I can possibly make it here. All right. So, at the top here, we're going to have Don Juan. You're inside the building.
Okay. So, Riles called out thunder, right?
Did you?
Yes.
Okay.
That was the whole point of me putting my hand on his knife and saying thunder.
Roger that. Sorry, we're getting ready for all this big fight here. You got a quick flash back.
Okay. As soon as I heard that and I hear what's up going on outside, I'm going to run over to the door and kind of like angle myself up on it and, take a look at these guys that are on the motorcycles. Because that door faces that road, right?
Yeah, it faces the road.
Okay, yeah. Can I, fast action move to, like, that doorway to where maybe I've got a little bit of cover and then try and take a shot at these guys?
All right, so coming up to the doorway here, I won't let me get you much closer than that, but we'll know that you're kind of peeking through the door. Let's see what your shot angle looks like. Yep, you've got that shot. He's right down the road from you. And it's going to be at a minus one because it's dark.
Okay. That is all right. I am still going to roll 8, 9. So still 8. That's going to be 1, 2 successes.
Okay. Lucky strike, bumping the damage.
Let's bump the damage.
Got it. Go ahead and roll that d10 for me, sir.
So with modifiers, it's a 6.
Okay. 6 is going to be back to my damage segment. Out of the vehicles. Into the damage and healing.
I believe it's 2.
I think that's a 2, but I want to tell you right.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I think that's fast. Quick tables. Damage tables. There it is. 2d6
minor hit. Yeah, so it's only 1.
All right. The shot flies out, impacting this fellow. Looks like it gets him probably in the arm. As he kind of recoils back, but quickly gets his arm back onto the rifle. That's your fast action, slow action.
Yep.
Webb, you're up. German's on deck.
All right. So I hop up. Okay.
You can see them from where you're prone currently.
Oh, I can? Okay, cool. I'll stay where I'm at. And I'll steady shot. I can steady aim and shoot in the same turn, right?
If you're doing a quick aim with your fast action, and then your slow action to shoot, I'll give you a +1 bump.
That's right. Okay, I want to do that.
Got it. Trying to make this map a little bit brighter so you guys can see a little bit better. That help any? It is nighttime. It's supposed to be pretty dark.
It helped a little bit.
Okay. They're right over here.
I'm keeping track of them.
Okay.
Okay. -1 for nighttime?
Yes, but +1 for your aim. So it offsets.
Okay. Two successes.
There it is. Bumping the damage.
Lucky strike.
Okay, you got it. I will burn my foo bar and have your round misfire as you get a clunk. Round doesn't go off. This M1 carbine, obnoxious as it is, some of the dirt that kicked up must have just jammed it a little bit, but you're able to clear it easy enough.
Stalk on weapon.
At least it's light. All right. Yeah. That's your go. Germans are up. Burke and Riles are after them. First guy who got popped was not a fan of that. He is going to take his shot at Corporal. That's who he sees. So let's see your stat block here, buddy. Range combat is going to give a 2-dice bump. Agility, which is 3. Total of 5 dice minus 1 because it's night. Takes him to 4.
Cover where I'm at.
Yeah, you're kind of like peeking out the door here. We'll see if he's even able to hit you. If he is, then you'll have a cover roll that you'll make.
Okay.
Try and reduce that. So taking this shot, he is going to shoot first. No successes as the round fires off. It hits the woodwork right next to you. He will now take his fast action to move. 10. He'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Kind of moving around the side.
Okay, now I've lost line of sight on him.
Correct.
Okay.
He's going to make his calisthenics check to see if he can sprint that and get all the way here. That is going to be 5 dice. No successes, so that's as far as he gets. Barry number 2. This infantryman will have a shot only on Webb, but it's you're prone for starters, which will be a minus 1, and it's night for another minus 1. So his 5 reduces to 3. With 1 success, though.
Okay.
Let's see, the damage on that is going to be a 3, which is a minor hit. Take 1 point of damage. Let me know where you're taking the hit in. Wounds, weariness, fear, or morale?
Wounds.
Okay. This is your first one?
First one.
All right, so your strength checks are at a minus 1, and you are considered nicked. The bullet impacts into the fleshy part of your shoulder, and you can just feel that immediate hot burn as it's punctured its way through that trap muscle on the top. That was his slow action, his quick action. He is going to advance as well. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8. You'll just go ahead and stop right about there. And last German we've got here, machine gunner, is going to take his fast action to move and brace that big old machine gun on the motorcycle itself. And he is going to, let's see, got Tuya's out there. He's going to send a full auto burst, which will give him a +6.
Ooh.
So this is a 6 + 6. 12 dice.
Ooh. Okay.
Jesus.
Yeah.
Well,
it's nice German, knowing you, boys.
German machine guns, man. That's the reason they call them a buzzsaw.
They were not a joke.
Nope.
And this is going to be spraying fire, though. He's trying to hit both of you, I believe. Mm-hmm. Increase that. Checking the thing. One of you is prone, so that reduces it to 11.
High time to 10.
10.
German to 2?
What's that?
He's German, so it takes him down to 2, right?
He should add another 2 for that mission.
Right.
Let's see. This is going to be multiple targets, so that's a minus 1. We're down 9.
Oh.
Let's see. All right. Yeah, I think it's just 9. We've got 9 dice as he is just unloading with the machine gun towards the two of you.
Mm-hmm.
6, 8, 9. 9 dice. 9 dice.
No dice, got it.
1 success out of 9 dice.
Holy. Jeez.
Got wow. Lucky. Goodness.
All right, let's Oof. See. Firing at multiple targets. I forget if that's you roll for each or if it's one for both. Let me check.
I think you need at least 1 success per target.
Okay.
And this is me just remembering. I would need to look at it.
That sounds right from when we had our one shot.
Yeah.
Okay. So we'll see who that was against first. On an odd, that was Don Juan, even as Webb. A 4. So that will be against Webb.
Of course.
Sorry, buddy.
My boy.
PSC Webb, the D10 on that damage is a 4. He has a plus 4 damage, which brings it to a total of 8, which is going to be 2 points of damage.
Oh.
A moderate hit. Still in the fight, buddy?
Still in the fight. One more.
Okay, where are you putting those? Your endurance is down by 2, and where are you putting those 2 damage?
I'm putting them in. I'm putting them all in, both in strength. I'm gas.
If you go all the way to 3, you're knocked out.
Oh, that's right. I'm sorry. Good. I can split these up, right?
Yeah.
All right. I put 1 in morale and 1 in, or 1 in morale and 1 in fear.
You got it. So just remember that those checks are going to be reduced by 1 when you make them. You've already been hurt, and the almost 150 bullets that come shooting out over the course of a couple seconds, impacting all around you, is just tearing apart your will to continue this fight. That is the attack against you, and now we will roll against Don Juan. 9 dice. It is 1 success again. Wow. These white dice suck.
Keep using them, it's fine.
That 1 success, oof. That's it's a 10 on the dice.
Oh.
Oof. Plus 4. Right? Is that the damage on the machine gun?
I think so.
42 plus 4. That's going to be a 14 damage.
Well, that's a mega crit.
That is 13 is going to be 4 plus. And plus 1 for each increment over 13. So it'll be a total of 5 damage on your endurance.
I'm down.
All right. The blast of machine gun fire peppers across. Let's see where that crit lands you, because you may survive it.
Does he get a cover roll?
Oh, yeah. Do I get a cover roll for that? Or does his machine gun have armor piercing?
So it's a minus 1 right for the cover. Oh yeah, you know what? You're right. Let's do that. You've got the door here. Let's see how much you can reduce that by. Protection and structures. The door. That is going to be 3. Heavy 3. So go ahead and roll me 3d6. Every success will lower the damage by 1.
Okay. That's one success. Can I push this?
Sure.
I certainly will. I've already got two bars. No more success. So just the one.
Okay. As you... The door, that will reduce it from 5 to 4 damage.
Okay, I'm still down. I only had 4 endurance.
Okay. So let's roll on this crit table and see where that landed you, buddy. Hit location. 4. Arm. Another arm gun.
Oh, no.
Let's see what happens on that impact. It's only a 1. That's pretty low. Flesh wound. Count your lucky stars. Other than a painful but superficial wound, you're okay.
Oof. Oh, thank goodness.
Let's roll and see if this is your left or right. This is going to be your left arm. It just blows a hole through your bicep. And you're immediately dropped to the ground. Just feeling the pain as it's searing. You're effectively out of this fight, but not dead. Oh, you will look like you are on this map.
Mm-hmm.
That is going to be the Germans' go. Burke, you're up, buddy.
Did I see him go down?
He's right next to you. You heard the shots ricochet. You heard a scream of pain and, like, probably his body slumped to the ground inside. But he's still screaming, so he's not dead.
All right. How far is that rock to my right, that boulder?
That's going to be 7 meters.
Okay, I will. Would I have a line of sight from there?
From the boulder? Yeah, you can have line of sight on one of them at least.
Okay, I'll move to the boulder, and then I'll pop off a 4 burst.
Sprint to the boulder. Got a kind of a limited little view here, but you do have some view.
Better than nothing.
Yeah.
So that's 4, 5, 6, 10 dice.
-1 for the nighttime.
7. Okay. 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 5 successes.
There we go.
Holy.
That's what's up.
No, 4. I'm sorry. 1, 2, 3, 4. Sorry.
Still good.
Oh, only 4 successes.
Rolled 9 dice. All right. So D10?
Yes, sir.
7.
Okay. 7 is going to be...
Is that plus the 3 extra if you added them to your damage?
No, it's 7. Yeah, 7 plus 3, so 10.
And we'll bump it to a crit. Go ahead and roll me a D10. Let's see where you hit. And actually, since he's got the cover here, you're going to need basically above 8. A 3 because you got... Yeah, okay. So it'll be a torso hit. Roll me another D10.
7.
Okay, excruciating pain, dropped to 0 endurance, consumed by the pain. 26 turns. Yeah, this guy is going to be effectively out of the fight as the rounds come blasting over. The one who dropped your buddy in relatively short order gets peppered by the rounds and drops to the deck.
And I will duck behind the, use the rest of my movement to duck behind that boulder.
I think he had like 1 more right there.
Are you 7, I think? That's fine, yeah.
I can get you 1 more then. Is that good?
Yeah, that'll work.
Okay. Next up is going to be Burke.
Riles.
I'm sorry, that was Burke. Riles is up next.
I was like, I'll go again.
Apologies.
You're good. Okay, so I'm going to move up and kind of take the corporal's position.
Okay. As you push your way into the breach next to your buddy who's been downed.
Um, when he fell over, did he fall over exposed?
Since you're not completely incapacitated on it, I'll say that he probably fell inside the building.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Does it look like he's bleeding out? Or is he still, like, again, since it's a flesh wound, is he still, like, competent enough to, like, pressure his own wound? Do I need to provide, like, I want to get that kind of sense.
He's probably going to be coherent enough to just be applying the pressure to it. But
like, there's two guys in this thing, right?
Yeah, there's two other dudes in here.
All right, well, I'm going to tell one of them to help him while I try to lay down some fire.
Okay.
That man has cover out there on that machine gun. So would the fast action be to, like, move to that door? Or I mean, would it?
I'd say, yeah, you guys are probably right up next to it by the point that all this started popping off.
Okay, so then could I take a quick aim to try to shoot that guy behind, to try to, like, shoot at that machine gunner?
The one by the motorcycle?
Yes, or is he too obscured?
You can definitely do it. This is called a called shot, right? So
minus four?
Minus five.
Minus five.
Minus five?
And minus one more because it's nighttime.
Well, hold on now.
Let's check that distance.
And then minus one because of night?
Yeah, that's 35 meters. So you're within your range. So no range penalty.
You got a BAR, right?
No, I don't. No, this is Billy. He's got an M1 Garand.
Okay.
Oh.
Okay. So
you basically need a headshot.
Yeah, I have two dice.
All right.
Do you have any lucky strikes?
I do have one lucky strike.
I think you can use it to bump your dice pool by two.
Yeah, that's the one PDF that's corrupted. So I've just been like, I'll just bump damage because I can't see what lucky strikes do.
Oh, buddy.
If that is the case, then I absolutely will try to do that.
Yeah, man, go for
and use the lucky strike. Does it bump by two?
That was what I was reading earlier.
Lucky
here.
Strikes. When you push your luck, you can re-roll with a lucky strike. You can add two dice to your pool, right? As long as it's not zero.
It comes out to the same thing in this instance.
Okay, cool. So then, I'll bump the dice by two and I'll roll four.
You can also change a minor plot point, like an environmental effect, bystanders, lost possessions. Yeah.
All right, cool. So I'll roll four dice on this one. Come on.
Oh, you can also use it to, like, hit the dirt or take cover. Get shot at.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. That's good to know for the future.
That'll be great to know.
I wish I'd known that a few seconds ago.
Yeah. Yeah, right, sure use that.
Another fun usage of it, you can re-roll a critical. Either one rolled against you or one you rolled against them.
Oh, just gotta read the PDF.
Oh, man.
Can we do a little redacting?
You don't read the rules. Yeah, we can retcon that. Did you have a lucky strike?
I have two, yeah.
Okay, you want to re-roll?
I will certainly force him to re-roll his crit if I can.
Re-rolling a critical result.
It'd be way worse because you got out pretty clean.
Yeah, you got a one on the D10 table.
Yeah, I'd take cover if I were you.
Yeah.
Want me to re-roll the result? I can.
Take cover and it takes the dice down by one.
Yeah, because I thought that the one was... Oh, so the forcing the re-roll, it's not a re-roll of the damage roll, it's a re-roll on the crit table.
Yeah, a re-roll of the critical result.
Oh, okay.
But you also could gain a fast action for the sole purpose of reacting to a ranged combat attack with a hit the dirt or take the cover action.
Yeah, could I have done that then?
Like duck behind the door or duck behind
duck
the wall?
Behind the roll back behind the wall.
Yeah.
I'm trying to find where the action is.
Can I use my two lucky strikes for environmental effect and have him get hit by lightning?
Out of the blue, God strikes you down for being a filthy, filthy American.
Nazi.
We have a capricious God.
Okay, let's... Just trying to go back to the actions here. See what effect that those actually have. You beat me to it, tell me.
Yeah. Trying to find it here.
But now we know, so we can't retcon this again.
Yep.
Yes.
Yep.
First one, 3.
Now I'll know to take more lucky strikes, because that shit sounds absolutely useful.
Oh, it's tremendous. Mm-hmm. Overwatch movement, post combat. Sorry, guys. Appreciate your patience here while I look this up.
I'm just enjoying these cool models.
Thank you.
Yeah, now they're looking real cool.
Age 86. Right, let's go to 86. It lets you go prone or take cover.
So, could I have, like, if I had used that reaction to duck behind the wall, would that have given me a higher cover roll?
Yeah. Because, I mean, you're like, you're peeking around the side of it. More? Yeah.
Because okay. I rolled 3.
Hit the dirt as go prone, take cover, provided some exists within 10 meters. Must elect to take either option before your opponent rolls the ranged attack attest. So, as soon as you know that somebody's going to shoot you, or shoot at you, that's when you need to burn that lucky strike and be like, I take cover!
Before dice are rolled.
Before dice are rolled.
Yeah. Okay, cool.
Oh, okay.
We can retcon it this time. But now that we know the rule,
mm-hmm.
we'll go from there. So you are back in the fight, not dropped. You can add those HPs back, but you are back within the building itself now. As you've kind of ducked out of the way at the last second.
Okay. So is that just a total miss then?
Yeah, we'll roll that as having struck the wall.
Okay, cool. I just want to make sure that's... Everything's copacetic.
Yeah, you're good, buddy.
Cool. I'm still, on my turn, I'm still burning. I'm still doing everything that I said I was going to do.
Okay. Yeah, you've
and
got.
That's 2 successes on that roll.
Wow. Nice. There it is. All right, go ahead. Are you going to bump the damage or take a lucky strike?
Take a lucky strike.
There you go. So go ahead and roll me that D10.
All right. Just give me an 8. Just give me an 8 or higher. It will be an 8.
An 8. There we go. Do you have a bonus damage from
that? That was a 6 on the dice plus 2 for the M1 Garand.
Yep.
Okay. You've got it. That an 8, I believe, is.
I think it's just the 2 points.
Yep.
Getting it back down to my sweet, sweet table. Yeah, 8 is a moderate hit. 2 points of damage. Right, we will reduce him down to 3. The rounds come, your single round comes impacting down. Let me roll a 6 for his helmet, because this is the only time that ever comes to play is a called shot on the head.
Mm-hmm.
A 6, okay. That will reduce that damage.
Damn it.
By a point. Which I don't think really matters.
So yeah, he'll drop to a 4 instead.
7. No, it's
Oh, okay, got you. It'll reduce
on the roll table.
Yeah.
So that's a 7, still 2 points of damage.
We're still good then.
Puncturing through the little ear flap and just ripping off the dude's ear. All right, let's take us back to the top of the at the bottom of the round. It's going to be your buddies. So, as for the buddies, the one is going to be kind of peeking out the side of the window, and you guys are kind of all clustered in here. They're going to try and burst their way out and go past you. You let them by, Chef?
Oh, absolutely.
All right. You're going to take... How far can they get? They're going to run right up next to this knocked out tank.
Hearing German screams inside.
Oh, those guys are dead, dead. Two dudes will kind of run up here and take cover for the moment. Takes us to the top of the round with Don Juan. You narrowly avoided death and have had an image flash before your eyes of a machine gun bullet taking you down, but you're back.
That was a close one. Can I try to, let's see. Can I run over 10 meters should get me up to like behind this tree, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, and then I should have line of sight on that guy that Burke was shooting at, right?
He did.
Oh, you took him out?
Yeah, he's big dead.
Oh, okay, cool. In that case, could I maybe try and move up ahead of these guys next to the tank and try and get a shot on Senior Machine Gunner who almost took me out?
So that's your full 10 to get here. You could do a slow action run to get you to 20, but that's going to take away your ability to pop off a shot.
Right. If I move up to the left, like closer to where those other guys are and run ahead, could I maybe do a calisthenics to try and get that extra few feet and on a fast action instead?
Sure. So going this direction, that gets you at your 10. And yeah, go ahead and make me a calisthenics check, please. Okay. Every success will move you one more meter.
That's two successes.
All right, two more meters up.
Yeah, I want to get like kind of right up against the tank and with a shot if I can here.
Okay.
Perfect.
Are you shooting for the machine gunner or for the other infantryman?
I want to take out that machine gunner.
Got it. So go ahead and make that shot. It's going to be -5 for cold shot because of his cover, and then minus one for the knight.
Roll 1-3. Okay. Got it.
There we go. Just one success?
Yeah, just the one.
All right. Roll that damage, buddy.
With the modifier, it's a 4.
Okay. 4 is going to be a single.
Yeah, point. Single point damage.
Got it. So that will reduce him from 3 down to 2. That is your go.
Okay.
Private Web. Sorry, I just realized the music stopped. What's up with that? More bumping. More combat. All right. Back to the action. Private Web.
All right. Well, I'm all shot up. So I have a lot of sight of the dude that shot me.
Yeah.
You know, obviously, he didn't move.
Machine gunner here. And then there's another dude right there. He's, nah, you'd be shooting right over your buddy trying to hit him.
All right. I'll try to shoot the machine gunner.
Okay.
But I'm just going to shoot him and I'll like to move afterwards.
You got it. So your shot's going to be -6 for cold shot and nighttime.
Three, six, two. But I could just sustain fire and shoot all the rest of my bullets.
Sure.
All right. Well, that'll bring me up to plus two.
Are you going for a suppressive fire?
Yeah, suppressive fire. Sorry, that's his name.
Oh, you're suppressing him?
Yeah, I'll do that.
Okay, so suppression, you empty the rounds. He'll have to succeed on a guts check, or basically he just has to take cover. But even on successes, you need a success to suppress him. It's not going to deal damage.
Okay, I like you're to just shoot.
Crazy trying to scare him.
I like to shoot suppressive fire.
Got it.
Alright. One success.
Alright, the suppression goes as all of your rounds start impacting into the motorcycle here. Let's roll a guts check for him. That's going to be empathy 3, guts 2, total of 5. That is one success. So he continues to stay into the fight. He's not out of it. Rounds are hitting close to him, but you didn't quite get him.
Okay. And I want to move in front of the tank to where they can't see me.
Okay, so fast action.
Fast action.
Go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10. Get you in the kneeling over here. I'm next to this.
Perfect.
Alrighty. Germs are up. Frickin' Riles on deck. Dude number one. He's going to go ahead and take that shot at you, down one.
Okay.
Do you want to hit the deck?
Yeah, actually, I have one more lucky strike. Let's go ahead and... can I try and roll back, potentially even out of the line of sight of this machine gunner?
Yeah, you've got cover within distance here. So... burn that other lucky strike. You should be down to zero lucky strikes now.
Yeah, I'm done with them now.
Kind of rolling out of the way there. Okay. The shot will just miss. It will take a fast action run. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. He's running up on this hill.
Oh, he's about to be dead.
Coming in at a full charge.
Full tilt bozo right into my BAR.
Machine gunner. Got Chef there in the door.
Lucky strike, go behind cover.
Yeah, nice.
All right, he's gonna still make a suppression. Try and keep you guys from popping your heads back out. Tired of getting shot at.
No lucky strikes left after that.
Okay. He was normally at 12. 6, 9, 12. Minus one for nighttime. Cover doesn't matter because I'm not trying to hit you, he's trying to scare you. I think we're good on that. Yeah, this will go for the other dudes in the house too. He's suppressing the whole building.
Those other dudes made it out next to the tank.
They're all by the tank.
By me, right?
That's right. Yeah, a single success. Dang, that's a lot of fives, but only 1 6.
So he's only suppressing me?
Essentially, yeah. He doesn't know how many other dudes are in there.
And then I need to make a guts check, correct?
Yes, sir.
Is Riles in? Riles is still in my zone, right? Like line of sight, at least.
Yeah, I'll allow it.
Okay, I have a cool head feature. You get a plus one to your guts roll here.
One success.
Okay. As you're starting to duck down and you feel Well, that gunfire is going to be done. One, your corporal calling out to you. What do you say to keep him in the fight here as you see the rounds impacting?
Say, Riles, get out of there and get out from under that fire. We need support.
You just hear like a muffled, Raj.
Rounds impact. That's that Jerry's go. Sorry. On the last go of it, your buddy over here was reloading. All of you that are out here, which is, I think, all of you.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
We'll look over at Lieutenant Colonel Gorm over there with his bazooka. And you will hear him say, "Get down!" He's going to shove that sergeant as hard as he can, which will not matter, as a tank round explodes, hitting him square in the chest.
Jesus.
Gorm or the sergeant?
They're both gone. It hits Gorm, it explodes, they're both taken out.
See, this is why lieutenant colonels don't do this anymore.
Yep.
This is why they just do paperwork all day.
The tree here is unmovable, apparently.
Theater of the mind, it's gone.
Yeah, it's gone. The tree is just...
just like a giant hole blown in like one side of it, and then it just like tips over on that side.
You guys both watch as, or y'all all watch as Lieutenant Colonel Gorm is just absolutely blown to pieces next to you. Your battalion commander gone. I need a guts check from everybody.
Okay.
And so everyone,
is that still a plus one for everyone? And with my cool head. Because I feel like I can see everyone.
I have cool head also.
I don't think they stack.
I'm gonna add. It's a minus one. This is auto hit. It's from a tank, so that's a minus two. Take a minus two on this guts check, plus from your cool-headed corporal. So for a net of minus one.
Okay.
One success.
One success.
Ooh, one success.
No successes. Guts check, or... reroll that. Push.
Got it.
One success.
There it is. Do you have any?
I'm already maxed on food bars.
Okay.
You're gonna bring the reign of, you're gonna bring the wrath of God down on us at some point.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
That tank is a helicopter too.
Got it. As that blast comes through, the ground is absolutely vibrating here. As a tank comes rolling in, this isn't some little Italian Fiat like you've seen. This big old monstrosity, whoops, there we go, that's about the right size.
Jesus.
Is a German Tiger tank.
Great.
One of the biggest tanks that they will field in the entire World War II. Very fresh and new, and ready for some action. It's rolled onto the battlefield, and with that round has obliterated Lieutenant Colonel Gorm. Now let's see about his gunner in the body. Put all the gun stats up here. Machine gun burst. He's going to try... Nah, he's got no shot. He did his big thing. He's good with that. Takes us past the Germans. Go. Burke, you're up. Riles on deck.
How far is that tank from me?
That tank is... right here.
No, the bad tank. The one that's alive.
Yeah. No, I'm trying to find you first. It's going to be 38 meters.
So even if I use my 10, I'm not in range.
Go ahead, Berg.
Oh, no, I was going to ask, is that German on the hill still up?
Yeah, he is still standing.
What I was going to say, too, is you could do, like, a hold action and the slow aim to where you get, like, some extra pluses on that tank for, like, holding it until it gets in range.
Yeah, I think that's probably going to be my best bet.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, I'll long swing the bazooka and I'll move slightly to the right. And I'll just go prone and take aim.
Okay, like this far over?
Not that far over, nope. I'd like to still be within cover.
Yeah.
Within 10 feet in case I need to burn that lucky strike.
That's why I'm asking. So, yeah, like right here, you're going to have that hill.
Mm-hmm.
That's kind of in the way of your line of sight. So I'm just trying to picture where you're moving to, like right here.
With that, I could fire over that hill, right?
Yeah, you can shoot over the top of it.
Okay, yeah, I'll be right there, and I'll unsling the bazooka and take aim.
Okay.
Steady my breathing.
With a slow aim, we'll give you a +2 bump when you take that shot.
Okay. I think that's it.
Got it. Private Burke getting the bazooka ready. Taking his time with a slow breath, Private Riles.
All right. So I don't want to run out that door in the middle of a machine gun man over there. So since I'm in the house, I'm just going to move out of the side window.
Okay.
And get closer over to like that rock where Burke's at.
Coming out the right window?
Yes. Right window, getting over to Burke.
All right. Easy enough. That's the window you guys came in the first place. So... call that 2 meters of movement. 8 will get you about here still.
Easy, because I want to get to where I can pop that shot at the guy on the hill.
Oh, okay. So 7 will get you right here where you can take that shot at him.
Yeah, and then again, I'm going to pop the shot and then hop behind the rock with the rest with that 1 meter left.
Okay.
All right.
So you're running up. This is the thing that I forgot earlier, and I apologize. If you're taking the shot while you're on the run, on the fast action run, take a -1 for that.
Gotcha.
Okay. Makes sense.
Slow action. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you can't shoot anyways. Yeah. So if you're shooting on the move, you're at a -1.
All right. That's easy enough.
And a -1 for nighttime as well.
Yep. We have 2 successes.
There we go. Lucky strike, or are you bumping the damage?
I'm gonna bump the damage on this guy.
Okay.
Give me that fat 10.
Hey, there it is.
So it'll be 13.
Ooh, a 13. Blimey. Go ahead and roll me that damage location.
D10 as well, right, or D6?
Well, let's see. D10.
Give me a 2.
That'll be a leg hit.
Okay. Give me a high number. Let me blow this dude's kneecaps off. 9.
Shattered bones.
Yes.
Blow has all but severed the leg, and he's bleeding out. Even if
give me his kneecap.
It gets him right in the kneecap. Just buckles under as the M1 Garand 30-06 round punctures it, and it just kind of very uncomfortably splits in the middle. As he immediately drops his weapon and is holding on to it, screaming bloody murder. Not killed, but definitely out of this fight. And most likely, if he does survive, out of the war.
Yeah, and as I get behind that rock, I'm just going to be like, Bark, you good?
Just punching tickets out here.
And I'm just like, please, God, handle that tank.
I'm working on it.
As you are getting ready there, next up in the initiative order is going to be Buddies. Let's roll their guts check from seeing the colonel blow. So soldier number one, with one success, staying in the fight. Soldier number two, with no successes, it's not. Saw the colonel eat it. He says, just very loudly, to hell with that. He's going to stand up and book it back. Let's see. Why are we doing that? That's weird. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. There we go. Now it's working, right? 20, and then taking the other 10. Full 30. This dude is just booking it back. He does not want to be face-to-face with a tiger tank. Especially when he has nothing he could even do against it. He's just out of dodge. The other soldier here, he's going to try and push his advance. Stand up, buddy. 1, 2, 3, 4. And we'll do a 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We're gonna have a calisthenics check to see if he can slide behind this rock.
Oh my god.
He gets it with one extra square here. He's gonna come in here just full on baseball dive. Sliding in. And he's going to try and take that called shot on the machine gunner. Heck with me rolling all these. Who wants to roll for him?
I'll roll for him.
Alrighty. Give me, he's only got five, dark as, I'm sorry. He won't even be able to make it. Yeah, because the minus six penalty.
Yeah.
And he was running. Yeah, he won't even be able to take the shot.
Roll
here.
Negative one dice.
Actually, do this. He can't shoot him. But what's the distance? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. What's the distance on a grenade?
10 meters.
10. All right. So yeah, he's just outside of that as well. He'll take his slow action to steady aim, kind of using the body of this other German to like brace his rifle.
It's got a 10-meter range, but it's got a 5-meter blast radius. So if he's within 15, technically a guy would still get a hit.
They make a perfect throw, though.
Okay, so if he's throwing it here, right, that's his 10. And then from there, yeah, he's in the blast radius. Let's have him do a full send yeet, toss that frag. So let me get someone to roll me five dice on a calisthenics check for this grenade throw.
Can do. Two successes.
There it is. Damage for a grenade. Anybody have that on hand?
I do not. I lost my grenades in my bag fell off in the jump.
Okay.
I do. For a, let's see. M1A1? I mean, M2A1?
Yeah.
Range 10 meters. Looks like plus one.
Plus one on the damage roll. Oh, the blast is
five meters.
Yeah. I was like, wait, oh my god, the M3. Okay. So let me get somebody else to roll me the damage here.
Go ahead, Boomer. Or never mind, go ahead.
So D10?
Yes.
Plus two?
7 plus 2 is 9. 9.
That'll be 3 points of damage. Looking up the motorcycle here. Motorbike with a sidecar. Yes,
if that explodes and kills him, I'm going to laugh my ass off.
He only has 3 health left.
I thought it was 2.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Because we got that one extra hit.
He does
see
have
what the cover does for him.
Cover from the motorcycle, yeah. So let's see. That does not. No successes on the cover roll. The grenade.
He wasn't expecting the yeet.
The grenade explodes. The motorcycle is wrecked. Just flip that over. And the explosion's blast shatters him with shrapnel. Machine gunner falls. Tank is rolling up and about to squish him. Good job, Brando. Brando NPC got a kill. All right. So, I hate to end in the middle of a combat, but you got a whole tank coming. You guys want to save this for next time? Or do you want to push?
I'm good either way.
I'm gonna end it.
Okay.
You gotta call it.
Yeah.
That's all good. So we will go ahead and save this bad boy right here. So you guys are on the attack, daring down one of Germany's biggest tanks. Ooh, a sweet fire. I'm gonna put that fire on this motorcycle. That's cool. You have knocked out some of them. You've taken out a handful of these Germans that have been attacking you.
Mm-hmm.
But most disturbingly of all is the fact that Lieutenant Colonel Gorm, your battalion commander, has been blown to pieces.
Man, I hope they don't promote Jonas.
What?
Oh, they will.
I've got an extra bazooka round. We're good.
Also worth pointing out is the fact that that encounter that you are currently in is a true story. Lieutenant Colonel Gorm single-handedly knocked out one Tiger tank and was engaging a second one when he was killed in action.
Damn.
Real person, real badass. That's how he went.
Damn. Also, too, what a badass last name. Gorm?
Yeah. Like
Gorham. G-O-R-H-A-M.
Yeah.
But still.
That's cool.
Real guy, a little bit of history. Hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you so much for sticking with us. We hope that you guys will come back next time and see if our intrepid heroes can survive the wrath of Das Deutsches Tiger. But these baggy pants devils, give them a run for their money. Thanks for watching. See you guys next week.
See y'all next week.